Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, I'll show you how you can get headers onto your tables or onto your trees. Something that ought to be trivial, but isn't entirely. So, as a good TV chef, I already prepared two classes for you. QTableView with inline headers and QTreeView with inline headers. And they look exactly the same as you can see here. It's actually the setup spans are slightly different for each of them. It's MIT licensed, so you can more or less take the code here and put in and just use this class going forward in your code. So let's see what it looks like. For the setup span of my table, I clear the spans, I then get the model here and I run through all of the rows in the model. And then I, for each of the row, I ask for an index at row, comma, column zero. And then I go and ask that one for the data, is this a title row? And this global row, :, is title row, is actually something that I implemented myself here. And is title row is an enum value with 42, 15. It needs to be unique across all of the rows. I haven't figured out a good way of doing that still, unfortunately. So I often end up grepping for enum class and looking for the hits there. Otherwise, if it's a title row, then I call set span on this row, this column, these amount of rows being spanned, just one row, and these amount of columns being spanned. And what QTableView will do then is to go and fetch the data of the row, the content of row zero, and just span that across all of them. Both the display row, the background, the foreground color row, and so on. I need to do this call setup spans whenever I set the model. And as it says here, I actually need to do that in lots of different places where my code underneath is changed. So if I insert rows, then I of course need to do this. If I remove rows, I need to do this. But might even be that my data changes. That's up to you. So hook up to those signals that you think are relevant for you. Now for the tree, it looks almost the same, same warning. I do this as part of the set model. The only difference is that this time I do not need to call a clear spans as I did over here. And I need to call set first column spanned with for this given row, this being the parent index, and then true or false. Why is it different here? Well, I guess it's two different people that implemented QTableView and QTreeView, and this guy over here didn't think it to be useful to be able to span only a number of the columns. I don't know, but in any case, this is the slight change in API. The final part that is missing in this is how do the model tell the view that it has a header row? Well, you already saw there was a role for that. And if you haven't watched that episode on communication between models and views, you should do so now, because there might actually be a bunch of proxy models in between. So I can't just call a method straight onto the underlying model. And besides, that wouldn't make this method, this new class here useful across a lot of different models. So go and watch this, there's a link below. Otherwise, just follow as I continue on here now. There isn't all that much to say about the code here. If we go and look at the table header with enum inline headers, whatever I called it, you can see that to figure out whether it was a title row, I called data method with this particular number, namely the 4215. I called that on the model, which will eventually end up in my underlying model down here, possibly through a bunch of proxy models. If the role that came in here is this particular one, then I should be returning its title row. How do I know whether it's a title row? Well, in my data set, if the year is -1, yes, I know it's a cruel hack, but again, my data is really just an example. In your code, you will know somehow that this is a title row. If we just look for this is title role, you'll notice that there's a bunch of other places where I use this. And you can see I also adapt my text alignment role. So usually column zero was left aligned, but if it's title, then it should be center aligned. Usually the foreground color was nothing particular, but if it's a title role, then it should be white and then the background should be black. And of course, I don't even want to go into the discussion of night mode versus reverse video, which KDE actually support. So if you have KDE users, it needs to be more complex than this, but otherwise this will do for now. And that's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. Do remember to connect to those signals before you use this in production. Otherwise, things will end up pretty strange. I'm Jesper Pedersen. I hope you enjoyed it. Do leave your comments below. And until next time, all you know, have a great time.